wrist. Throw metallic knife, I can shake it out with. I just put a drum on a no kill tick. I just put my cum in a pussy nose wet.
It's up and stuck. Thought you can cross the game, what was you thinking of? Red coupe, roller coaster sound just like it does. These days I balance all the hate out with the love. These days I pour all of my pain out in a cup. Dreamy, that's just a side effect when you with us. Easy, the dust is right behind me, they on edge. Believe me, we pop out in the city to collect. Vibes in this bitch, they surprised that I live. Track can be killed, try the terms, but I'm still. Hop in the whip, top right in the whip. Box in the whip, got me.
They make it out with snake, slang it out. Shake it out with. I just put a drum on a no kill tick. I just put my.
All right. Hello, guys. Everyone can hear me? Yes, awesome. So, wow, today I will not make the mistake. I will record, or somebody's recording already. Good. Awesome. So first of all, I'm super grateful and happy that you made the time. You are here today. I know most of you are working. Most of you have your family and your job and your priorities, but you are here to move and to somehow put yourself on the next level in trading. And today we have a special guest, somebody who really touched my heart. The way how he speak, the wisdom that he has the same age as me. He's 20 years old. He's a Go Life educator. I think currently he's a P2000. I know that it's not his priority to build, but he's more like trying to help people to re-educate them. I really like the way he is teaching. I really love how he's able to talk about the mindset and the value that he is adding during his sessions. And that's why I felt that it will be great to have him here today and somehow give him some questions and hear his story and really get the connection with somebody who is successful like him. So I hope we have Leon Davies now ready here. Is that...
Yo, what's good? Can you hear me?
Yes.
All right, awesome. Yo, legends, it's a pleasure to be here. Bear with me 1 minute, I'll be back. 1 minute.
Guys, chcete překlad? Nebo není potřeba?
Yo, can everybody hear me? Wait there, what? Yeah, you good?
Perfect.
All right, awesome. Legends, it's a pleasure to be here. Thank you for being here today. I'm going to bring as much value as I can within the space that I am here. I don't know if you need a translator whilst I'm here, but obviously you guys obviously understand perfect English, which is fantastic. There are some calls that I obviously need a translator for as well. Because of the accent, you know, I'm originally from the UK, but, you know, I do live in Australia, Melbourne, and, you know, my life's not always been this way. You know, I've not always lived financially free. I've not always been in a place where I've been able to, you know, travel the world and obviously live from wherever I am in the world. And, you know, it's a pleasure to be here and just drop as much knowledge as I can through the markets and mindset and psychology to really break down the education through trading. Because a lot of you on this call right now might know how to trade already or just learning, or some of you are in depth with when it comes to trading, but what you got to understand when it comes to trading, it really comes down to the psychology aspect. It really comes down to, you know, having a $1 million mindset, because some of y'all, you know, you might have good money already, or some of y'all might have good jobs already, but you got to think we've come from the employee state to an entrepreneur mindset. And to make that transition is very, very complicated, especially if you've been brought up, you know, just knowing how to work a 9-to-5, you know? So if we can really just dig in depth as a businessman or a business lady and really take on as much knowledge as we can when it comes to these charts and when it comes to educating, we will do so. And we'll really give a rundown on the charts and obviously the psychology behind it at the same time as well. So if I can share my screen, which I will do. Host, I need to share my screen. if you can. All right, awesome, awesome. Yeah, there we go. All right, legends. So, you know, there's certain things that I look for and I identify within these markets. And NAS 100 is probably one of my most favorite pairs I like to trade. And I only like to trade NAS 100 with Hugo's Way or with a certain broker, because obviously it pays out a lot differently than it would with IC markets. And IC markets, you can only use a standard per trade with NAS 100. But that works out to be around about a 0.1. A standard on IC markets is about a 0.1, so like a dollar lot size. It don't pay out as well. And that's why I like to use Hugo's Way with this, because I am actually 1,000 pips deep on NAS 100 as we speak today. And obviously I'll show you the before and after. Here was the before, and this was my entry point. As you can see, you know, I don't hide any of this. This is a before and after. This is the date and time when I actually marked this chart up. And I'm gonna be very transparent with you guys today. If you see anybody posting charts without this above, they've done a pre-recorded video of a before and after chart, because you can hide the time and the date of when it was scaled out. So, you know, as you can see the date and the time right here. And we go on to this one, you can see it's a completely different time as well. So this is the before and after, you know, I'm very transparent. And I won't need to trade for the rest of the month. Just imagine that. Just imagine placing one single trade and not being able to, or not have to trade for the rest of the month because you're 1,000 pips deep. Just imagine having 1,000 pip month every single month. Now, this is the thing, legends. A lot of people are looking to trade every single day because they think every single day they need to make money within these markets. They need to place trades every single day. And that's not correct. And the reason being is because you don't need to trade every single day to become a successful trader. It's actually the opposite. And a lot of people think, oh, I need to be on the markets every day. No, you need to learn every day, correct. But you don't need to place a trade every single day. And you got to understand, this is a skill set. You know, a skill set needs to be learned before you earn. You know, what do you do if you take off the L of learn? You earn. So you got to understand, you got to learn before you earn. And a lot of people come in this industry and don't understand that. They think, all right, cool, I'm just going to come in, I'm going to learn, I'm going to earn without actually having the learning process behind it. So, you know, you got to understand, if you've already done your percentage target within 2 days, the rest of the days, back test. Go and learn, all right? Go and study. Don't try and come onto the market and make any more money when you've hit your daily target, your weekly target. And this is where a lot of people go wrong, because they become greedy within these markets because all they want to do is make money every single day. Did you know the more trades you place, the more risk you got to lose the profits that you just made? People don't realize that. They think, all right, cool, if I trade every single day, I'm just going to make more money. No, you're just actually risking the profits that you actually made. So me, I'm more of a guy of like, if I trade less, I got more of a chance of holding my money and holding my profits to trade another week. And obviously allow that as well. There's people in the waiting room if someone wants to allow them in as well. I don't know if you want to do that, but I can't do it my side. But that's the key to success, legends. It's about understanding trade less and hold longer. Now, if we go into NAS 100 real quick, as you can see from my entry point, this thing has dropped 1,060 pips, you know, so that's a decent amount of profit and a decent amount of pip count of one single trade. Now, if anybody was on my session this morning, you would have seen most of these setups did not fall into place. There was no rejection candle off that trend line. AUDUSD, there was no rejection candle off that trend line, right? AUDJPY, there was no rejection candle off this area. And that's the key, that as you can see, there was no rejection candle from this area. It broke straight through. I'm not trying to place every single setup that I see. I'm just waiting for one setup to fall into play. That's all I'm doing. I'm just waiting for one single setup to show me signs of what market is doing. Some people are looking to place every single trade setup that gets sent. They're looking to trade every, I'm just looking for the perfect opportunity where all confirmations line up at once. And if they don't, then that's okay. It's fine. Because I know tomorrow there's another trading day. Now, guess what? Like I said, NAS 100, there is no reason why I need to trade. I've already cleared that profit. I am looking for a 3,000 pip target on that. Is it going to reach it? I don't know. Is if it reaches it, do I care? And the reason being is no, I'm not. Like, I'm happier taking partials when that thing moves 1,000 pips. Like, I'm good with that. You know, depending on how much money or should I say lot sizes you put on that. With it, why I like Hugo's way so much is because obviously you can use very, very small lot sizes and get paid very, very well with these specific pairs. You know, I have separate accounts. I have IC markets that I just trade normal FX pairs. And then Hugo's way, I trade US 30, I trade Bitcoin, I trade NAS 100, USR, and oil on that account. The reason being is obviously the payout is a little bit different. But what I want you guys and girls to understand on this call today is that you don't need to feel that you need to be placed in every single trade or every opportunity that comes in front of your eyes. You just need to find that perfect setup. Now, that perfect setup obviously comes within time. You know, and this is what makes someone successful when coming into the market, is having that determination and patience to understand that trading is not about over trading, and it's definitely not about over leveraging. It's about identifying certain things and then reacting when all confirmations lie with the confirmation checklist that you have, and obviously have a trading plan. That's the beauty with this skill. A lot of people ask me, Leon, how do you have such a good mindset? Well, when you've been trading for 5 single years and you've gone through trial and error, and you've gone through so many diverse things and studied so many different strategies and been through the works of life and struggled financially and struggled, you know, being an independent person, then you understand what don't break you makes you. And it's this is what I always tell my team. This is what I always tell my people. You do not grow in your best times in life. It's impossible. You only grow within your darkest stages in life. When shit is getting really bad, that is when you grow. You don't grow when you're happy. You grow when you're going through dark stages. That's why I like to be put through pressure. Because I know at the other side, I have to grow through that. And it's definitely a lesson to be learned. Some people just can't handle that pressure. And losing an odd trade here, there, you know, 10 pips, 1% losing of their account is too tough for them. And that's why there's only a certain amount of people that become successful. It's because they can handle the pain, they can handle the pressure. And that's what makes them successful. It's because they understand it takes a lot of pain and it takes a lot of pressure for you to become successful. God only puts his strongest warriors at the front line. And it tests you a big amount of times in order for you to see if you're even worthy of any success. You can't expect success to just fall in the palm of your hand without no, you know, nitty-gritty stuff happening from the works of it, you understand? So you got to understand, you got to go through that. And if some of y'all are 3 months deep, a year deep, or even 2 years deep within trading and not seeing any success yet, unfortunately, it's just not your time yet, but it's coming. And it just depends on how long you can go through that pain before you actually become successful. Me personally, I was like, you know what? I can't give this up. Because I see too much potential in it. I'm too deep. I've studied way too much. I've put too much time and effort into learning the craft to even turn back right now. But some people are cool with that. Me personally, I wasn't. I was like, nah, I can't. It's impossible. Can't do that. Right? So that's NAS 100. Also have AUDCHF from this mark, as you can see. And I actually didn't place this trade. But, you know, that's all I literally look for. I look for a trending market. I look for a nice level of support and resistance. And basically, I just get into the trade when it starts making a rejection from that area. You know, what day is it today? It's Tuesday, right? So Tuesdays, Mondays are not particularly my best trading days. You know, I normally have an odd little loss here and there on a Monday and Tuesday. But on Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays, I always make up for it. Now, NAS 100 is made up for my month. You know what I mean? And that's the crazy thing about it. People are going to let one trade, two trades, three trades affect them, that they don't really understand what's coming around the corner. You know, and that's the cool thing about it. You've got to understand, like, you've got to focus on the wins of what's going to happen rather than the losses that's happening right now. Some people like to focus on the losing days and then they drag that onto the next day. They drag that onto the next week. If you only focus on bad, you're only going to attract bad. If you focus on your bad trades, you're only going to attract bad trades. If you focus on a positive day, you're going to have a positive day. You're going to have positive friends. You're going to have positive people around you because your energy is contagious. And when it, let me speak on a fact of energy right now. The reason, guys, why I'm speaking so into depth of the psychology when it comes to trading is because it's the most important part. I don't care about the skill. I really don't. The reason why I'm successful right now is not for the simple fact of necessarily the skill. It's the skill behind the skill of me developing the mindset of what's got me in a position that I am right now because of the markets and the way that I analyze them mentally in my head. Pressing buttons, lining up charts, drawing a bar, drawing a diagonal line. That's a skill set that you see with your eyes. But mentally is a skill set that you need to develop and no one else can do that. I can show you how to trade. That's perfectly fine. But I can't teach you how to think. That's your lesson. That's something that you have to develop. That's a brain that you have to design. You know, everyone's completely different and learns in different ways and have different ways of learning things. But for me, look, this is 5 years into the development of me having this psychology fact of the mindset and the way that I do on these charts. This ain't just an overnight success sort of thing. You know, this is 5 years in the making. So you got to understand, you got to be willing to sacrifice a lot in order for you to get to a certain place. Are you willing to sacrifice 4 years of your life to never work again? Are you willing to sacrifice a little bit of money to never work again? Are you willing to sacrifice a little bit of family time, you know, with your friends or whatever it is you're doing to never have to work again or to have financial freedom or to be able to travel? And that's something that you will ask yourself. And that's something that I asked myself. I was willing to do that. I was willing to escape everything in order for me to come back and obviously, you know, come onto these markets and be financially free as well. So that's why I dig deep into the psychology of fat legends, is because it's the most important part when it comes to trading. And it's not taught enough. It's really not taught enough. And the reason being is because you understand not everyone has that developed mindset in order for you to make fantastic money. You know, like I said, we come from an employee mindset to an entrepreneur mindset. And it takes a lot to make the transition, you know, into that state of mind as well. So, but that is all I really look for, legends. I didn't really want to dig too deep into the chart right now. Wait there. Let me just move this. I didn't really want to dig deep too much into the charts aspect because y'all guys can watch me every single day, really, on Go Lives and watch my recording. But what you legends don't really get to have is a one-to-one or a psychology aspect of trading, which, you know, obviously I'm on this call for you guys to do right now. But that's all I really have. And that's what I really got for you guys and girls right now. And obviously now it's just a patiently waiting game. Now I'm off the markets. You know, these markups I have to leave to just give you, you know, of what happened yesterday to today. And then obviously tomorrow on the go live, we will look at brand new charts. So, you know, that's what I do. And, you know, I have to keep them marked up. Otherwise, I would just delete them right now and obviously look for some more markups. But I'm off the markets now. You know, I've already got one successful trade. I don't really need to look at the markets today. I don't even need to look at the markets the rest of the week. I don't even need to look at the markets the rest of the month. It's the 3rd of November right now. But I have to because I'm a Go Live educator. You know, something that you guys and girls have got advantage above, you know, Go Live educators is that you don't have to be on the charts. I have to be because I have to teach. There's so many times I want to go on to Go Live and like, guys, today, unfortunately, I'm not on the market, so I don't want to educate, but that's selfish. That's me being selfish, like, all right, cool, I don't need to educate today because I've done my targets. I've done what I needed to do. You feel me? But I don't really need to be on the market. So sometimes I can be a little bit lack and slack because I don't need to be trading. You know, and that's why it can be, you know, draining sometimes because you got to understand, like, when you're not supposed to be somewhere and you're there, just imagine going to school, right? just imagine going to school and you finish school and you hate school, or you don't hate school, you just don't need to be there. And then the teacher says, you got to come in today. Why? Just because you have to. I'm like, but I don't. And that's what it feels like coming back onto the market. You know what I mean? So it can get kind of, you know, draining from time to time, but it's what I do. And I'm passionate about teaching you guys and girls so you can get to that next level as well. Is there any questions you want to ask me personally before we do end this call and run it up as well before I do go? But let me know.
Yes, we definitely have questions. So thank you so much for this amazing wisdom. I actually want to just hear from you if you remember the time in your life when you have this switching moment when you realize that you need to change your approach and into the market. And if you remember what happened, if you can share your story a little bit.
Yeah, so I used to be a guy that used to do a one-to-one ratio. So I used to be trading one-to-one. So I'd look for 30 pips and my stop loss would be 30 pips. So I would have to win every single trade in order for me to become successful. Like literally I had to win every single trade. Then I realized my trades were going way more than 30 pips. So I was like, okay, if I can try and figure out a way where I can minimize my stop loss and have a higher reward, that's going to make me less stressful about winning every single trade. And then it's going to put less pressure on me of worrying about the markets at the same time because my stop loss is so minimal. So that's when I had a moment of like, all right, cool, now I need to make that transition. And a lot of people don't allow that transition to happen because their ego is way too big. They think that they got a strategy. They stop learning. They're making a little bit of money now. And then they wonder why they're going backwards is because they stop educating themselves. And that's what ego, that's what happens when ego steps in. So I've always been a student to these markets and still am today. I never stop learning. I never stop educating myself within the markets. And it's a constant growing sort of thing. So, you know, back when obviously I started, but you want to think, legend, like I was a year into trading. I didn't see any success for like 9-10 months. You know, I was just blowing an account. I blew five accounts, and my sixth account was successful. So don't get it twisted. They wasn't very big. You know, it was like $100, $200, $300, $400, and then like $300. They were very small accounts, but until I got to my last account, which was $250, and that was all the bit of money that I had, I realized I had to be very careful with it. I just knew I had to be very cautious with the trades that I was taking. Risk management was there. I was using 0.02, 0.01s. And then obviously I flipped that account nicely. And then from there, it's just been history. So, you know, stop trying to take small accounts to big accounts and just let that thing grow, you know, organically. Don't try and over leverage it just to try and get it to that next peak. You know, have a compound plan. You know, and stick to your rules and stick to your guns until you hit six figures. And trust me, it's worth it. It might take you a long time, but when you get there, it's definitely, definitely worth it.
Oh, awesome, awesome. Thank you so much. I have a lot of notes. I also have another question. And if someone else's question, you can write in the messaging. So what is your vision for future, and who was your mentor, who inspired you? I think that would be also very interesting to hear.
Yeah, man. So, you know, I didn't really have a lot of mentors before coming in this industry because I wasn't brought up around entrepreneurship. I wasn't brought about investing. I never knew anyone before I joined IAM. IAM is the first ever company that I've ever joined in my entire life when it comes to investing, when it comes to learning a skill set. And I didn't know anything different apart from, you know, what I know on the street. And, you know, when I come in this industry, I used to inspire by, you know, Matt Rosa, Jason Brown, but I never had any trading mentors. When I first come in this platform, we had three go live educators, which was Christopher Terry himself. There was Chris Derrick, Mike Miles, and Lex Waves. So there was four. And there wasn't much of a platform. So I had to do my own diligence. I had to go on YouTube and really figure out what it was. There wasn't a lot of back office, what you guys and girls got right now. There is no excuses of why you can't become successful in this industry, because you've got so, so much that you can just learn from. The only thing that's going to stop you from becoming successful is you yourself. There's no one else that you can blame apart from you. So, there wasn't really a lot of mentors that I had, but now I've come in this industry, Bob Proctor, Les Brown, Dr. Joe Dispenza, Tony Robbins, David Amitié, all of these guys now are people that I listen to on a day-to-day basis. I would have never knew them about them before I joined this industry. So I've not got trading mentors, because I've got my own strategy. I don't feel that I need to learn a different strategy if I've got something that works for me. But there's obviously tweaks that I can do with my strategy to make it better for sure. And obviously that's what I do every single day to make sure that I'm not just feeding myself better, but I'm feeding everyone else. And putting money in everyone else's pockets as well as mine. And my vision is obviously to impact, the world, to leave a footprint, to make sure that I die with a legacy, to make sure I be remembered more than just money, jewelry, chains, and nice cars and houses, is to make sure that, when I die, people remember me for what I've done, not what I had. So that's, that's how I want to go on the world today. So.
Wow, nice. Thank you so much. We have another question for Václav. I know Václav is also a Go Life educator in Czech Republic, and he's a big fan of you. I actually found you thanks to him. And his question is, do you work with DXY? And if yes, how?
Yes, sir. I'm on DXY. Yeah, I love it. I thought you was on about HFX. No, I'm on HFX, but DXY, is that drop shipping?
No, dollar currency index, DXY.
Oh, DXY. No. That's me. That's not me. No, I don't work with that. No.
Okay. Interesting. Is the reason why?
You understand, I'm not a institutional trader, so I don't really need to look at the DXY if I'm looking for certain movements. I guess that's used mainly for the US dollar, for gold. I don't trade gold a lot, I don't really need to use that for the style of trading that I use, but I know a lot of people use that, and obviously have a lot of success with it as well. So, but me in particular, I don't use that. No, I thought you was on about products, then I was like, yeah, there's loads of products that I use.
That's interesting. Okay, we have another question from Daniel. What drove you forward when you didn't have much energy, motivation, and resource?
What keeps me motivated?
Yeah, what move you forward?
Like pillars, I guess, being young, I want kids one day. I want to make sure my kids have the best life. I want to make sure that, I'm always independent and I can give what I can to my family and future. I want to make sure that, I want to provide for the people that, I raise, and make sure my kids are going to the best schools and they don't have to worry about money. So it keeps me going. You have different, I think the more you start making money, your goals always change. Your goals don't always remain the same, because you hit certain goals and you're like, all right, cool, now I've got a new goal. And obviously that is what keeps me going. It keeps my brain occupied. It keeps me moving. One day, obviously I want kids. I want to make sure that, I can take them and obviously take them to school and whatever it is that they can do. And obviously they'll always be around a father figure. So I just want to be the best father figure I can possibly be to everyone that's around me.
Nice. That's amazing. Wow. So, I'm really, really deeply appreciate you. If we don't have any questions, I would not take much of your time, because I know that your time is pressure. But if you are open, we will really enjoy to maybe see you again in 1 month or whenever time you open for it. I really appreciate it. I have a lot of notes. We also record it, so you can watch it again. So, one more time, thank you so much. Thank you, all you guys, to be here today, to learn together, to do some impact in the world, and have a nice rest of the night.